Okay. Let me try and explain what this is all about. And I'm not going to keep you for more than about 15 minutes, okay? So first, the rules are you need to stay on the e-book, okay? I'm going to show you a short film which kind of explains what this is all about. What it's about is providing resources for you that are readable on an iPad, okay? So like the other day in class, Olivia had a load of these revision booklets that she bought from Science. For how much were they?
£3 each.
£3 each, you know the CGP resources that you buy, yeah? And I looked at those, I thought, well, what about if students could actually look at resources on an iPad, right? And what if they could get these resources and they have film in them and stuff like that? So this is a little film that explains that. And then we're going to have a look at one of these ebooks and see if you like it or not, and hopefully you will. And if you do, we're going to make more of them.
Touch gloves, yeah, it'll be all right. I always knew you had a heavy heart. Brother, brother, you're taking me back to the start. I saw your face in a photograph, painting a picture of a better time. Brother, brother, you'll always be on my mind. Yeah. In a perfect world, in a perfect
this school teaming up with a school in Turkey, a place called Bursa. And what happened was, some teachers went there to Bursa, I went, Miss Khan went, and some students went. And we collected together all the information and we put it in this e-book. So you've got this e-book in front of you and you can see the pages along the bottom. Now what I want you to imagine is just like that video, that we could make these books for you to help you with your different subjects and to help you with, if you're a student who has English as an additional language, we could build in some interesting features like translation features. We could put videos inside these books. We could put animations inside these books. We could put web links inside these books. So if you're struggling with GCSE biology, you would just download the book that you wanted. So if you think about this book, but think of it as an example of what is possible, then you start to get the idea, okay? Now you saw on that film that there was like a library of different titles. For example, GCSE biology, for example, you know, study skills in English, and so on. And the idea is that teachers write these books so that you could access them, okay? So you could access them independently, but also the teacher could stand at the front like this and they could talk to you about pages that are in the book, and then when the teacher's finished talking, you've got the book in front of you and you can do further exploration, further learning, right? That's miles better than a PowerPoint, because a PowerPoint is just a copy that's on the board, okay? And you don't have a copy of it on your desk, so you don't sort of have the ability to go back and forward according to what you need to do. So this is an idea, this is a technique for providing resources for you. Now, I want you to have a look at this, and I want you to have a read of some of the pages, and I want you to just try and get an idea of what the Connecting People Planet project was about, and you're going to be filmed while you are doing it, okay? So that will give us a flavour of how you like using these types of books. And then I'll ask you a few questions about whether or not you think this is a good idea or not, or whether you think it's complete rubbish. Okay? Okay? So you have a look now, and bear in mind that we don't want you looking at the cameras, we want you to pretend that the cameras are not here. Yeah, you can write notes, that's not a problem. You'll notice that you can select parts of the text and make a note. Okay, thank you for doing that so well. Right, so let's just try and take some feedback, hopefully positive feedback, about how you think this would work. First of all, do you think this would work, Olivia?
Yes, I believe you would.
Why do you think that it would? What? Go on.
I think it would work better because as like time goes on, technology is becoming bigger and bigger, so it gets teenagers more involved in it. Plus, it's a smaller compact thing, like anyway.
Thank you. That's excellent. So two reasons there: technology moving on, and the fact that you can take it anywhere with you. Vlad.
It would be better. From this country, because they can easily translate why teachers don't speak other languages except from English.
Yeah, brilliant. There's ways that you can use translation features on these books. So if a teacher doesn't know a language, not only that can the teacher access a translation, but the student can access a translation. So it's very good for independence, okay? Ashley, what did you think about these? What was your idea about this stuff? Thank you. How many people, the show of hands if you'd like to see videos in these types of things? And what about audio? Yeah?
I think a combination of both.
Combination of both, Olivia. Excellent. Right, now I'm also starting to think, one of the things I like about these books is that you can have web links in them. So if you want to find out more about a subject and there's not enough room in the ebook, you can click on that and it takes you to a website, right? So you can use links to websites. You can also have interactive features in them. So you can have things like quizzes where you are asked questions at the end of the chapter and you make choices, and then it tells you how many you got right. So it checks your understanding, yeah? You can do so many different things. You can put games into them, word searches,